Financial Sense Insider is a premium subscription service of PFS Group. The following is a free preview of today's Insider interview.
Joining us on Financial Sense News Hour today is Avi Gilburt of ElliottWaveTrader.net. And Avi, last time we had you on the show, you made some pretty, I would say, troubling comments for perhaps gold investors. It was in July of last year. You said that you didn't think we had seen the bottom in gold yet and that there would probably be one further flush. And then if we were to test the 1180 region, which we have done that today, we've broken through 1180, that it could even break down to 1,000 and perhaps even as low as 700. Give us an update on your outlook given the current price action that you see now with gold.
Well, last year, if we remember, when we broke down below there, my initial target when I was using the GLD, which is what a lot of my people trade, your initial target was 109. We were looking, once we broke through the lows from last year, we were looking for a bounce from there and then head down to those lower low targets. But the manner in which the initial bounce took shape told us that it looks like the market's going to be pushing off. You know, once we went through December and so on and so forth, it was clear the market was going to be pushing off those lower lows. So when we started getting this massive run up into early this year, you know, many people just turned very, very bullish, thinking that, yeah, we've now hit the absolute bottoms and the bull market's back. And my perspective was no. To me, it was just a corrective bounce. I still think you're going to see those lower lows. I think you're going to see 1,000 tested and potentially broken. Whether or not we extend all the way down to 700, I cannot opine about just yet. I need to see how the structure sets up to take us below 1,000 for me to know better.
So the weakness in gold today is largely being attributed to the strong dollar, and that is a reaction to today's jobs report on the day you and I are speaking. Jobs data came out, and it was estimated that U.S. hiring was at 295,000 last month, and that this number had beat analyst forecasts again for the ninth time in 12 months. So we have had a very strong string of U.S. economic data, and of course, we see the dollar rallying on that as traders now expect that there's more evidence that the Fed will raise rates this year. So how much of this weakness in gold do you think goes back to the dollar and the whole Fed rate outlook?
Hi, everybody. John Loeffler here. You know, you've just been listening to a free preview of the Financial Sense Insider Premium Edition. Do you need help making sense of the market? I mean, you've heard the old adage, it's a jungle out there. Well, you know, you can join our premium weekday service and you'll gain access to leading experts, analysts, and market technicians on what's driving the markets, the economy, and your future. You can get all of that by subscribing today at financialsense.com. That's Financial Sense, S-E-N-S-E, like you're trying to make sense of something, .com. And click subscribe to join our premium weekday service. You won't regret it.